guys. I don't see any leaks other than what I got on it from when I changed it. Thumb comes back quite a bit. I should be able to dig with that now. I got a package of greaserts coming. I think I'll leave this up once the sun goes down just a little bit more. The garage will block it, and then I can work on extracting that. And I think I'm going to get the greaserts all switched over. I got back of it all tore apart. This is just popcorn sheet metal. This should have been made out of solid plate. That would have been a great counterbalance. I got the think I'm gonna mount the cooler right here. It's got its own built-in fan, and I can run the wires up into the harness somewhere. And then I got a filter coming. I believe this is the return. Disconnect it. I'm gonna mount the filter block right off from that. And then this hose has got to go to the input of that cooler, then from the output of the cooler to the input of the filter, and then from the output of the filter into the tank. And then I gotta change the fluid. I'm gonna change the oil. I got this all apart. One of these plates fits real nice up in here, except for I'm gonna have to cut a little section off, and then I'm probably just gonna grind a little spot and put a spot weld here, and maybe one over here and one over there to hold the plate. That'll add about another, I think them are 25-pound plates. That'll add another 25 there. And then I'm gonna do a plasma cut out the holes on the bottom. I'm gonna stick another 25-pound plate there, so that'll be a total of 50. And then I think what I'm gonna do is, this is cast, I'm gonna try to weld, cut up some bits and pieces. I got a sheet of sheet metal. I think what I'm gonna do is braze or weld on an extender, probably 4 inches, and build the same shape as this, but out 4 inches, and it'll be hollow. And I'm gonna fill it with lead, I think, or maybe cement, and then bolt that back on. I'll show you the sheet metal I'm talking about. I really gotta get my lawnmower fixed. The grass is getting pretty tall. It's getting rusty, but it's pretty good stuff. I think I got a sheet of that still at work, so I'll have plenty of that. I should be able to do the sides. I don't know if I'm going to fully weld it. If I fill it with lead or cement, this stuff probably bores a lot of you, but I don't know. I'm just spitting off ideas, but I'll probably drill and tap this and put a few long bolts, thread it right through and bolt it in, so I got something for the stuff to, so it won't come loose. But I think between them plates and stuff, that'll be plenty. If I had a little bit more ground clearance, I'd probably bolt one of them yellow plates up underneath there, but I don't know, baby steps. Right now the thumb is working, so that is a bonus. I've always wanted a thumb. Now I finally got one. So yeah, I'm gonna post the other thumb on Marketplace, I think. See if I can get some of my money back. But yeah, so I did some horse trading with my buddy. Same buddy that did the powder coating for me. I don't know if he wants to be named or not, but I traded a tractor attachment that I never used, and he's got a full-blown big plaz table or whatever. I might have to come up with a steel or whatever, but he's gonna plaz cut out all the brackets and stuff I need. And I think what we're gonna do is mock up a you know, I don't know, maybe I'll use that big piece of angle iron that what is that, 5x4 or whatever I got, 6, whatever that size big angle iron I got, maybe we'll do 4 inches under the motor or whatever my longest point is, and then across it, and then another one to protect these. But he's gonna fab all that up. I don't know if he's gonna weld it together, if I gotta weld it together, either or, it's not a big deal. But I'm gonna take the whole machine over to his place, but it's about 3 weeks out before he can get to that, and that'll give me plenty enough time to sort out the hydraulic routing and stuff on how I want this. And then what I'm going to do, I talked to the hydraulic place that got me them fittings. I'm just going to take the whole and put the whole machine on the trailer, and I'm going to truck the whole thing over there, and we're going to pull right up next to the hose building or whatever, and he's, that way they can sort out, I might plumb it and put it all together there, or just get everything and then come home and plumb it. But I really, really think that's going to be a huge bonus to this thing. And any hydraulic unit should have a filter on it. I don't know what them Chinese were thinking. I really wouldn't mind. There's room. I could scoot this thing, you know, back quite a bit farther. And there's room. I could have put another hydraulic tank too, but I don't know. That's my goal, guys. But baby steps, one thing at a time. At least finally something went right up here. So yeah, right fittings to do the job now. So alrighty. Oh, I picked up all my weight that I had back here and threw back into my weight box. I am really slacking. I need to get this tire. I bought tubes for both back tires on this thing. I need to get these things off and put the tubes in there, make sure there's nothing that's going to poke my tubes, and then I need to get them over to a tire shop and get that rim guard put in. And then I really miss having weights on this tractor. So But my daughter needs me. So you guys take it easy and have a good one.